Hello everyone, Cherries Red Army, club football's back, match day vlog, match day 12, Bristol City versus AFC Bournemouth. It's been a very tough week for Bournemouth, for the club, for the fans, for the players, manager, and more importantly for David Brooks. Unfortunately, he received some terrible news that he's been diagnosed with cancer. That said, he looks like he's got the best support possible, and we are all sure that David Brooks will beat this and be on the pitch very, very soon. The players would have been determined to get a result today. We lost top spot. They're going to want to regain top spot after West Brom won last night. But more importantly, they're going to want to put in an even bigger performance today and get those 3 points for Brooksy. We hope we're going to meet up with some fellow fans before the game, get that pre-match feeling. And then let's hope it is a good performance from the Cherries. If you're new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. We'll really appreciate it. At some point in the video, hit the like. And also, let us know your thoughts in the comments. If you were at the game, if you watched the game on TV, or if you've seen the highlights, let us know your thoughts. We'll read every single one. Looking forward to this. It's a nice journey up to Bristol. Really positive that the players are going to get the job done. Let's get those 3 points. Let's go back to the top of the league. Let's do it. For David Brooks. Come on, you Cherries! Foggy conditions on the way up to Bristol. Bit of Michael Bublé playing in the car. Bit of a family outing today. Got my father-in-law Keith, he's designated driver. First game for a long time, Keith. How you doing?
Yeah, doing fine. Looking forward to today. And, hopefully 3 points.
Debut on Cherries Red Army. Got Owen in the back there. Got his Bournemouth cap on. How you doing, Owen? What's your score prediction today, Owen?
A 2-1
win to Bournemouth. Got Carl in the back as well. Good mate of mine. How you doing, Carl?
Yeah, not bad, mate. Thanks.
Feeling good about today?
Definitely, yeah. 3-1.
Come on, the Cherries. Let's get back to the top of the league. Michael Bublé. Going to be one question on every Bournemouth fan's lips today. Emi Marcondes or Gavin Kilkenny? Well, what we're going to do in 5 seconds, everyone, we're going to say one or the other. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Marcondes.
Kilkenny.
Still quite not sure who won there. Maybe that was two each. Not sure. But Emi. I'm your biggest fan, I follow you until you love me. Ryan, Ryan Christie. Superstar, you know that I'd be. Ryan, Ryan Christie. Lineup's coming out very, very soon. We're in the Bristol Beer Factory. Found Aaron Hayden.
Very good, thank you, Kirk.
Excellent, another away day. Looking forward to it?
Very much so, yeah. It'll be a tough game today, but hopefully ruled on by a big travelling contingent.
So what we're going to do, bring some entertainment before the lineups are out. We're going to go for a quick fire five. This is five questions coming your way. Just give me an answer out of the questions that I give you.
Fine.
Okay. So, cardigan or gilet?
Gilet.
Hot dog or pie?
Pie, 100%.
Kilkenny or Marcondes?
Ooh. Marcondes.
4-2-1-3 or 4-1-2-3?
I think it'll be 4-1-2-3 today with Pearson City.
Yes. Cherries win or Cherries draw?
Yeah, Cherries win, obviously.
Lineup's coming out soon. Minutes till kickoff and lineups are out then. Few surprises, no Smudge, no Pearson. I'm hearing it might be to do with injuries. No Lerma, but that's not a surprise. International travelling and obviously Stoke on Tuesday. So Kilkenny comes in, assume he'll pick up the hot wing midfielder role. Christie did tuck inside with Billing. And Jamal Lowe gets his first start of the season, likely to play right with Jaden Anthony left and Dom Solanke. Jack Stacey picks up right back. So an opportunity for some of those players that have had limited game time to get a good run out.
Will they settle in quickly? That is the big question. Will we start slowly or will we start quickly? Hopefully it doesn't unsettle us, but it is a good opportunity for those players that we've talked about to get a run out and show their worth in the team. Hopefully it's going to be a good game. The boys can perform well. David Brooks, they're all currently wearing Brooksy shirts. Pre-match warm-up. Come on, you Cherries. Home fans got behind Brooksy. Come on, the Cherries. Half-time then, Bristol City 0, AFC Bournemouth 2. Almost a perfect plan has come together. Although the first 20 minutes was a bit scrappy, we had a couple of quarter chances, slashed at a few chances, but nothing real clear-cut. But then we did get our first goal on 20 minutes. It was a turnover of possession. Christie got involved. Then I think it was out to Jack Stacey, and he put in a perfect cross from the right-hand side. And Jamal Lowe got his first goal for AFC Bournemouth. What I loved about this half is every time we lost the ball, we worked really hard to get it back instantly. We had great energy, great turnover, and the second goal would come again just before half-time. It was Jordan Samora, that man in form, having a brilliant season. He shot from a tight angle on the left-hand side, almost went top of the net, fired straight in. We celebrate, going 2-0 up. We've been here before, haven't we? I hope we come out and we look for a third and don't try and sit on this 2-0. But a great first half, and let's see what the second half brings.
Thank you. from how this game is only 2-0. We've had three or four great chances in this second half already. 60 minutes gone. Christie and Kilkenny, they're pulling the strings and everything good that we are doing. Bristol City, though, they're coming into the game now and they have had a few half chances. One was squared across and the striker couldn't get onto it. Finally balanced this game at 2-0. Need that third. Need that third goal.
How this game is 2-0. Would love to know the shorthand. We have absolutely pummeled Bristol City's goal in this second half.
He knows exactly what we need. Kelly at the back, Slacky in attack.
Finally back home, an amazing away day. Got to see so many fans, so many friends. It was really was a great day out. Atmosphere was as expected. One of the best atmospheres for a very, very long time inside the Bristol City Stadium. On the pitch, so many, many good performances throughout, including the players that have come in that have barely played any football. Lowe got his first goal of the season. Christie was all over the pitch. Stacey was fantastic with his overlaps and he created the assist for the first goal. Kilkenny, magnificent. Don't recall, still thinking about it all the way home. Don't think he missed one pass. Almost 100% pass completion, surely. He was fantastic in turning over the ball, recycling us back into attack. He was just absolutely fantastic in that holding midfielder role. And he also got us on the attack, spraying those diagonals wide. And that's what Kilkenny can give you. But yeah, a fantastic day. Clinical in the first half. Jordan Samora also got on the score sheet. Second half, should have put Bristol City well and truly to bed. Could have been 5-0 up inside 60 minutes. Should have been 7-0 come 90 minutes. But we're getting into the areas. Just we weren't clinical in the second half, which was a shame. But we got the 3 points. Bristol City really didn't look like scoring. They had a slight few chances, but nothing real of anything to concern us. And we got the 3 points, went back to the top of the league. Really, everyone got behind supporting David Brooks. It was a fantastic moment in the 7th minute. And then continued probably every 10 minutes after that. So get well, Brooksy. 3 points were for you. We move on then. Quick turnaround straight into midweek. Tuesday away at Stoke on the channel. I'll try and get a preview out with the quick turnaround. So hopefully keep checking out. Hit the notification bell so if a preview drops, you don't miss it. And then we're going for a watch along. Not had too many successful watch alongs. Well, from a performance point of view, obviously we had the Birmingham 2-0 and an uneventful 0-0 against Peterborough. But we go again for a watch along. So check out for details for that on Tuesday. For this one, though, we really appreciate you checking out the video. Let us know your thoughts in the comment. Also hit the like. The Cherries got the result, 2-0, 3 points, clean sheet, great performances all over the pitch. Another great weekend for the Cherries. That's for you, Brooksy. Until the next video, we'll see you soon.
Up the Cherries.